So I guess. Okay, that one first. Okay. Hello, my name is Avi, and I do hair. I'm located in Lafayette, Louisiana. My Instagram name is Lace by Avi, and today I will be demonstrating a frontal unit install. So first, I already have my client braided down. You would braid the hair. You would braid the hair going straight back from the forehead to the nape area. And then you will get a cap. It could be a pantyhose. I prefer pantyhose because it's thinner and it'll melt easier. But I just use a regular cap from the hair store. But you'll choose a cap that's closest to the client's hair skin tone. You'll choose a cap closest to the client's skin tone. So when you get the cap, you'll put the cap on and you'll spray with Got to Be Free spray. You can either place your client under the dryer, or if you're doing it on yourself, you can place yourself under the dryer or blow dry it. I prefer to dry it because it hardens faster. So the unit we have is a 20 inch body wave unit, but I blow dried it and I bleached the knots. Okay, so you already have the cap on. You'll take the unit and place it on the client's head or your own head. And you'll just get it to see, make sure it fits. Pull this out. Put your head to the side. And you'll just get it to fit to where you're covering up the cap that you have under. And you see how you can still see like the cap underneath? I'll end up cutting some of it off, because the more cap you have, the further it goes down, the further your frontal goes down, and you don't want it to go down too far, because then like you don't want to take up your client's whole head. Okay, to pull it back, I'm just going to take some tweezers. And lift it up some. And whatever you lift it up, you just take your scissors and you cut it off. Make sure you don't cut yourself or your client. It's your cash back, and Discover is matching it. Discover Cashback Match. What are you waiting for? Learn more at discover.com/match.
What can happen when you get the diamond heart pendant from Helzberg Diamonds this Valentine's Day?
I'm gonna do other
a surprise for you.
The mechanic figured out what the weird sound was?
It's better than that. Here, open it.
It's gorgeous. I love it.
And I love you. So, happy Valentine's Day. Right now at Helzberg Diamonds, save $400 on a half-carat total weight diamond heart pendant. Just $299.99. Tap to shop Helzberg Diamonds Valentine's Day gift guide.
Okay, now you're gonna try the client's unit on again. And if you have to tug, that's fine.
So you're going to New Orleans?
Oh, I'm back on to New Orleans. It's a Facebook now. Thank you. Okay. Now that you have it on the client's head. And it fits correctly on both sides. You're gonna start to cut the ear tabs off. So for this, I'm just, you can like what it says. You take it and you section off the area that you wanna leave. Okay, once you have it sectioned off, you're gonna cut and you wanna cut the area that would be covering the top of the ear. But you don't wanna cut it too short, because then it might not lay right. So you're gonna go from the bottom on up. And this is the first ear tab that you would cut off. What kind of wig is that and what length? Where you purchase your hair from? Okay, my client purchased her hair off of AliExpress. It's a frontal unit and it's 20 inches long. It was body weave, but I washed it and blow dried it, so now it's straight. Okay, now once you have that side, you go put it on. You're gonna go around to the other side. And you wanna make sure everything is measured up as good as possible, because cutting it now is how it's gonna be installed. So if you don't cut it to the right thing, you'll be kinda messed up. And if you have to tug, that's fine. Okay, now you have both of your ear tabs cut off. You can take the unit off. And now you see how we still have that line where you can tell where the cap is. You're gonna take some makeup that's closest to the client's skin tone and rub it along the cap. And this is so you won't see the line anymore through the lace. And you can drag it back a little bit to wherever the part may go. Okay, once you have that done, this is where you can start with your layers of glue. I'm going to be using the Ghost Bond. And you're going to do 3 layers. So I start off from the middle. And I either put dots or I just drag it along. Bye. And he could take a popsicle stick or the end of a rat tail comb or something and just smear the glue evenly. And you could kind of drag it back all forward a little. Because you're kind of remembering where you're placing your unit at, the front of itself. You don't want to drag the glue like this far down because your lace not coming this far down. Okay, now while the first layer dries, I go in and I cut the lace off of the unit. And I use a razor. You could use scissors, but I use a razor because it'll give the lace a jagged look. Okay, so I have the lace off now, and as you can see, the first layer has dried, and you know it's dry when it turns clear. So now we're gonna go in with the second one.
Her name is Avery. I hope you're out there.
And you want to make sure it's spread out evenly, because if it's not, then it won't dry clear and you'll have like little white clumps underneath the lace. Okay, now while that layer dries, you're going to take the same makeup you took to put on the client's cap or your own cap and place it on the lace. And you don't have to fill up the whole lace, you just want to focus on the hairline. And you're gonna do it from ear to ear. And you could use a foundation or a powder, but I prefer a foundation. And not a liquid foundation, like a press. That's what they use, a press foundation. And this is just gonna help with the lace melt even more. Okay, this layer is clear now. So we're gonna go in with the last layer of glue. Now with your last layer of glue, you don't want it to get all the way clear. You still want it to be a little white because you want it to dry with the lace on it. But don't put it on while it's fully white. You want it close to clear, but not all the way. Okay, and while this layer dries, you can start to get your unit ready on where it's going to be placed. Okay, so now it's clear enough to where you can start to lay your lace down. So I start off with the middle first.
I have a question. You cut your lace before you install?
Yes. And when you're placing the lace, you don't want to press too hard. You just press in softly. Because being that the glue isn't dry all the way, if you press too hard, then the glue will start to go through the lace. And I like to take my comb as well to press it in. And like I said, if you have to tug on the client's head, that's fine. Just make sure they're not in discomfort. Like in discomfort.
They look like scalp already.
Okay.
No, I put it
together
with the belt. And was it pre-plucked or you customized it?
I customized it. Even if you get a pre-plucked wig, I suggest plucking it some more. Maybe once it's on your head. Because you want it to fit as close as possible to your natural hairline. And I would suggest putting something, I don't know, like a wax stick or something on the hairline itself so that the flyaways don't get in the glue. I didn't, but I suggest y'all do that. And if you are making your own wig, I suggest like making it a little bigger than what you would like usually make it. Because you want enough wiggle room for your frontal to where it'll fit all around your hairline without any problems. And it's better to have it bigger than smaller because you can always put in an elastic band. And my client's wig is a little bit smaller than what she could have went with. So you just gotta make sure you're holding it in place, because the lace can pull back. But you don't want to pull it too hard, because you could rip the lace as well. And I'm just pressing it down with the pin. Now I'm asking her to hold this side because remember I told you her wig was a little snug. So I don't want, when I go to the other side, for it to pull and lift up. And when I'm pressing it down with the comb, I'm pushing the hair back and pressing the lace forward. And this is just helping everything set in without too much pressure. Okay, now that I have it on, I'm just gonna go through and see if there's any parts that's lifting up that didn't get in the glue. So I have a part right here. Your first three layers of glue was to just put the unit in place. Now you're gonna go in and you're gonna take the end of your comb, or you could just use the bottle itself, and just go in and place little drops. And this is just to lay whatever part may have not get touched. And when I do this, I don't really let those parts dry too much. I just press it down.
Being somewhere to swim in the pool in the gas station, open up the tank.
Okay, once you have your lace in place, you can either take a scarf or an elastic band, and I like to use an elastic band, and you're going to wrap it around the hairline. And you're gonna tie it around the hairline. And this is just to ensure that the lace and the glue is melting together so that it'll stay. And you wanna pull it tight, but not too tight. Okay, now usually I would sit my client under the dryer for about 10 minutes, but we don't have a dryer, so while the lace and the glue is melting together, I'll just start to style her, and she's going to be wearing a side part with curls. What side do you think? Are you parting? Alright. So, at this point, you could go however deep you want. And when I do side parts, I don't like my part to just be straight. Like, I don't go straight like this. I kind of curve it. So I'll start like this, and I'll kind of drag my comb around. Yeah. Do me a favor then. I need you to take my purse and buy me some clips. I don't bring no clips to keep the hair the way. I don't even much know. I think you're in the front, but my bag right here. Okay, and now we have our part. And I just look at it from the front to see if it's not too deep, if I want to go up some. I think I do just want to go up a little bit. But if you like it really deep like that, then you could keep yours deep. And you want to make sure you push in some hair back so it could cover the last track on the unit. Even if it's a machine made unit that you ordered already made, it'll still have a track that you need to cover, so you just want to make sure you're leaving some hair to cover that. And you want to try to get your part as clean as possible. Some frontals have the density is higher, so it has more hair, so sometimes you'll have to go in and plug the part. But her frontal density isn't that much, so I don't have to go in and pluck it. I'll just define it with makeup in the end. But to make sure your part stays in place, I'm gonna take a wax stick on Jackie's, and I'm just gonna put a little bit because it's really heavy, so it could weigh the hair down if you put too much. And I'm not like pressing hard. So you're gonna comb out the wax stick a little. And I'm gonna take my hot comb And if you don't have a hot comb, you can use like a wand or a curling iron, but I just prefer a hot comb. Yeah. Ain't gonna press the hair. Try not to burn. Don't let it sit too much on one spot. That's just a stick. I thought she was stuck in the new job. But yeah, you don't want to sit it too long in one spot because it could burn your client. This is the part so far. Maybe it's cordial. Yeah, scrunchie on this. Anybody? Thank you. So to start styling it, of course you put it across. So you do want to kind of layer it just a little bit so it could have some definition to it and the curls won't be so flat. But just make sure you comb your hair out first. So I'm just gonna take the same razor that I used to cut the lace and I'm gonna section off a part, and this part would be to frame her face. So I'm gonna measure it up with like her jawline. I'm just gonna take my razor and I'm gonna go from the top. And layering does take away a few inches. Okay, now for this side. You wanna section off a part again. But this time you're not gonna line it up with the jawline. You're just gonna eye it however you want the curls to fall. So I'm gonna cut it like about right here. Should I turn her back when I start cutting?
Yeah, you can. It's gonna mean you wait a little.
Now, to color hair, I'm going to be using a flat iron, the Babyliss Titanium, and it's set to 450. And first, before I start coloring, I'm going to spray with some heat protector. You can use any kind that you have or that you might like. This is the one I like. Alright, I'm just going to section her hair off. Clip it away. So I don't really take small portions. I guess you would say like medium size. The bigger the portion you take, the looser the curl will be. And you don't want to take it too big though if you're using a smaller flat iron. And you just want to comb through. So first I go in, I kind of straighten it out a little bit. One pass, and in my second pass, I start to curl it. And you're curling away from my face. And you're twisting it as you go down. Twirl it around. And then I let the curl sit in my hand for just a little while. Kind of scrunch it up so it could kind of hold. And then you just let it go. Wait, what'd you say?
It was so nice.
That's how yours is looking.
I need my 101.
I saw yours just looking like that the other day. Okay, I'm gonna take another one. Kind of straighten it out. If you going from body wave to curling it, I would suggest just blow drying it out so you can get the waves out. Your curl is gonna be more neat. Or if not, you could flat iron it first and then curl it. But blow drying is easy. And you like clamping it as you go down. And you just spin it around a little bit. And you let it go. I like curls with the cutting iron. But the flat iron gets them tighter. So they kind of hold for longer. Okay, when you switch sides, you kind of turn the curling iron different. Before, I was like this. But now, I'm going to pick the hair up and come on top. Because if you curl the same way on the other side, you won't be curling away from the face. You'll be curling towards the face. And you want it away. Now you see how this one goes like this, and this one comes like this.
How could you
I thought my mom was making me something.
Yeah.
Forever.
Really? Mm-hmm. You know, Instagram have like the album. Okay, so on this side we're almost finished, so I'll just section off and finish off on this side. And I'll just make this one whole curl. And I like to go in with my hot comb first and make sure the top is flat. And the curls that's closer to the face, I try not to make too tight. Because you kind of want them to fall just a little bit. And I probably hold a flat iron maybe 5 seconds, if that.
Trademark and also see the trademarks of other types, including the Thin Mints marker owned by Girl Scouts of USA, limited time offer, distribution, and distribution. 36 days. That's how long it takes the average company to want their next.
Now we're on our last section.
And Glassdoor hires are committed. They're 30% more likely to stay with your business tomorrow. Go to glassdoor.com/hire. Glassdoor. Find the right fit for your business.
I know, that's what it seemed like. It seemed like it's further away.
Okay. I'm gonna have to move it. I have to push that light.
You
have to
push it back.
Yeah.
Excuse me. Girl, what I think is that we deleted my whole life. Because that damn song came.
Oh.
Lord. You know when they say container yeah. song? I don't know what it is.
Okay. Bring it up. It's back now. Okay. Okay, now that you finished with the styling, we're gonna take the elastic band on. Okay, this is how it should look. Once the band comes in. Okay, so I'm just gonna clean up the parts. Okay, now I'm gonna start sectioning off parts for my baby hair. I already have the first, I guess you would say, sovereign parted out. But before I start on my baby hairs, I like to push the hair back, but I'm not gonna. I just take that wax stick that we used earlier for the part, and I just place it on there to push it back. Right. For the baby hair, you want to make sure you don't have it too full, but it's thin enough for me. So I'm just gonna take the razor and I'm gonna cut at an angle, like going down. And you could either use foam wrap or gel for your baby hair. I prefer the gel because I won't have to let her sit under the dryer or anything. And I squeeze a little bit on my hair. And I want to take it in place.
What is the difference
between the wrap and the foam? The wrap, like, I would, the gel, they hold in place easier. Versus with foam wrap, I would probably have to blow dry them or something. I'll put it under the dryer and tie it down so that they can hold. And all depending on how much baby hair you like or your client want, that's how much you'll do. I'm just gonna keep it simple, so I'm only gonna do like 2 on this side and then about 3 on the other side. And the shorter you cut your baby hair, the more natural you are. What's up, man? I cut off because I saw because it didn't do that for Eminem.
Right.
So it started out lower?
I don't even know. No, it's the. You see, I could have Oh, you want another one right here?
It's up to you.
I think I'm gonna like this. Might be too strong.
It looked nice too, even without none.
With none?
Yeah.
I don't know. I think I have a thing to give
it on other people.
I put me some this time. I really like. And if you have like some excess glue or too many flowers, you can take some alcohol, the clear alcohol, 91%. Put it on the towel and just kind of rub. Don't rub too much because you don't want to rub your lace completely off. And if you do have too many extras, I just pull them out. And sometimes when you do your baby hair, if you see there's a part that you could go in and pluck a little more, you could do so. Don't pluck it till you have like a ball spot. And remember to cut at an angle and cut short. Oh, and the gel I'm using is She's Bomb Glue. And you don't need to put too much gel, just enough to where you can move the hair around.
This a lace install.
I had some twice. This week. I'm done with it. So I like this.
Thank you.
just, it was
bad. Ooh, this awesome.
Good. Come on. God, no, I'm not going to wash that over, huh?
I'm going to keep it over.
Okay. So now we're done with both sides of the baby. And this side, I think I'll click it just a little more. And I'm gonna take that wax stick again and put a little. And this time, I'm gonna take my hot comb. Now I'm gonna add some wax to this side. And like I said, don't put too much because it's kind of, it's a heavy wax. And I'm gonna take my hot comb again. And this is just to give it a little shape, keep it in place. The wax also helps with the flyaways. But now we could comb out the curls. Dang. And you don't have to comb out with a comb like this. You can use your hands. I use my hands for the back because I don't want to comb it out too much.
I'm
gonna get back to the side to make sure we clean up. Okay, now we have two final steps. Okay, next, you could either plug the part, but her part doesn't need to be plugged. So I'm just gonna take the same makeup that I took in the beginning, put it on the brush. You don't need too much. And I just like to dab it on my hand first to kind of get some of the makeup off. And I'm just gonna follow her part. To me, it's looking like a 13x4. Because some 13x4s do come a little bigger.
Yeah, I don't
know. And some of them come smaller, too. It just really all depends on where you get it from. But I don't think it's a 13x6, because her middle part wouldn't go that far back. And after I do that, I just rub it in. Because you don't want it to be known that it's makeup. Now next, the gel kind of dries like a little white, so I would take either some oil sheen or some oil I'm just using bio silk, but you can use whatever. Rub it on my fingers and kind of rub the baby hairs. Just so they don't dry up white when she's at home or something. Now the last final step is I take some all shoe and I just spray. And I take my hot comb again. Okay, and then you're all done. We're gonna start from this side. This will be this side.
Can you turn her?
Like this one.
Yeah. Thank you, my really nice.
Thank you.
Full spin, love.
I'm going too fast.
Too slow.
Oh. Alright, hold on. Was that a time lapse?
No. Oh. I'm just doing a regular video.
Oh, alright, hold on. We're going to go again. Oh. When you turn, kind of we'll get this. Yeah. Alright. Tell me we were. Wait, restart. I wasn't ready. Alright, yeah. It's been too slow. Wait,
what? You are
come on, man. Alright, move your head like this. Like tell me when you're ready.
I'm ready.
You need a fast spin too?
Yeah. Wait,
which way I spin? Like this, alright. Alright, one, two, three, go.
You should have like a little slow motion thing.
You got that?
Mm-hmm.
Wait, what you ask for the girls? They should have. Oh, like when I combed it out or something. Time lapse.
Oh, really?
No, they have slow motion on the phone. Yeah.
I'm gonna try it. I'm
kind of like. Let me see. Yeah, combed. Wait, I don't think I turn it on. Like this?
Yeah.
That's slow-mo on the phone, man. Get back there. You know
they.
Yeah, I'm finished. Okay. Can you send me the picture?